And society.
All right. For society.
All the Magna Group.
Listen.
All the Magna Group.
The cover is society. But I thought this is being covered by Stardust. Am I right?
Right. Also, how does it feel to have received the Padma Shri
award? Ah, I've got to be a bit grim on that, right? It was very nice, really. It went, it felt very different. It felt very elating, very inspiring. And then it makes you wait for the Bhushan. When do I get the Bhushan? So I started the Ramesh Sippy Academy for Cinema and Entertainment. I'm hoping this will get me the Bhushan. What do you say? Worth it? You think so? Okay.
So how was the whole photo shoot experience for Society Magazine?
Oh, it was a lovely day, and I think I gave ample time. I was told I was very nice about it.
Definitely.
Yeah. How can they say no? No, it was very, very, very nice. I actually opened up, warmed up, and therefore it went on and on.
I think he overstayed.
Really, really long time.
And it's always in his hands to cut off whatever is not necessary. So I left it to them to keep the best and throw away the rest or use it somewhere else. So it's always, now these days you don't throw away.
So it's now time for us to reveal information that both you and I don't know about Ramesh. So, and for that, we will have to talk to his gorgeous wife. Firstly, how does it feel to see your husband on the cover of Society?
It's, every time I see it, I feel fantastic. I mean, it's never that, oh, I've seen it so many times. Mm-hmm. But this is really, really looking, I think he's looking handsome, don't you?
Oh, yes, he's definitely. I said it in the beginning, he's tossed all the young actors.
Yeah. So, besides being a great director, if he can look so handsome, mm-hmm. I feel good about it. But I'm sure he's shared a lot of good things with society, which the rest of the people will be able to read and understand and identify with. In fact, I had to come down because I was up and he was giving the interview down, and I had to finally come down and say, like, it's not over, you know, because it went on and on. So I think he spoke from his heart that day, and he shared a lot of his thoughts on various issues, and I'm hoping that the people who are going to be reading it are also going to get to know. So a lot of things that are here, I would not like to talk about.
So now coming to the information that you and I will be really interested in knowing. When you are angry with him, how does he make up? What does he do?
Well, it never gets to that because it's like talking to a black wall. So I could be angry and shouting and saying, but what the hell? And I'll just see this man nodding and smiling. And if it's anything to say that, you know, you were wrong, it's like, yeah, you're right. Yeah, I was. And when somebody says that, there's nothing you can do about it.
So then what are the certain things that you like and dislike about
him? So this is something that irritates me about him.
Okay.
But on the other hand, it's wonderful because you never really get to the level where you fight. Mm-hmm. But sometimes, you know, you want the other person to react, but he doesn't.
But just apart from that, which is the best quality this man
has? Patience.
Patience.
I tell him that, you know, if there was a bombing happening around you and if you were reading a book, you could very peacefully carry on reading, wait for
the
bomb to happen, and then close the book and say, all right, let's go on, you know.
Ramesh, you're truly having a great day today. I'm all flattered by the compliments and comments. All right, super. So now it's time for you guys to ask questions and start the conversation. So who's going to start? Kindly raise your hand. Yes.
You worked with the generation that is now quite senior, and now you've started your own academy and seeing the next generation. What is the?
It's not the next generation. It's three generations down. 18-year-olds today. 18-year-olds today. They'll be entering the academy.
Yeah.
So my grandson is more than that. Oh. My grandson is 24, 25, 20. Well. So you can imagine that I am feeling really good.
What is the main difference you see in both of their attitude towards the industry or towards acting?
I think the common factor is passion. When you're young, you're very passionate, whether it's going to see a film or wanting to learn about life, all aspects of life, of course about romance and of course about the ticklish bits, but the curiosity and inquisitiveness about life around you and the desire to do something, especially if they're coming to this kind of a business. Yes, there are a lot of stars in their eyes, but if they are movie makers, they would come to my academy more if they want to be movie makers. Everyone is welcome, but I mean directors. They really want to be directors. Then I see that if I can pull out one or two every year that can do something like magic, then we have a great future. More and more generations of movie lovers will be able to see all that. What that's going to be, I don't know in the future, with technology changing the way it is so fast. You can see anything on your mobile, you can see anything anywhere, probably on a wall, probably, I mean, it's all around you. And then to keep the interest of that audience who's used to so much would be quite a tough job. It always was tough. It's not getting any less tough now.
All right. Yes,
My question is for Kiran, ma'am. Like, you both are tar couples of Bombay's social scene. So what do you think about that tag? Tag of being a tar couple?
Well, I mean, why should I be unhappy about it? It's a great tag to have, along with, luckily, we're not just that. We're doing a lot of other things, and we have a fulfilled life, as you call it. So it's great. I wouldn't like to be only that, definitely. But it's great.
Yes? Yes? Yes?
It's written on the cover of your life before and after Sholay. So how much did your life change after Sholay?
Not really. At least I didn't personally feel it. Because I have been more or less what you see today, as she said. Even Salim Javed once said to me, it looks like you were born mature. So if that's got any truth in it, then I was, what should I call it, a dreamer, always. Somehow, the one thing that drove me all to do things was, A, I needed a challenge, and B, I wanted to make films, if not better, at least like they do in the West, that like they, the masters in our country have made films. Why can't we take our films to those levels? And it was always the feeling within me that said that take that extra chance, be a little different. That's why my first film, Andaz, was about a widow and a widower. Everybody said, you crazy? You want to make a young guy? 25 years of starting a film. And you want to make a film about, you should be making a film about young people. Exactly what my actor, hero, Shammi Kapoor said. You know what I'm popular for, famous for? The rebel star, the dancing star. Don't you want to make the most of that? All I said to him was, haven't you done enough of that? Let's do something different. He was excited. So let's do it.
Yes?
Sir, मेरे आपसे दो सवाल हैं. पहले सवाल जब शोले रिलीज हुई थी तो जिस तरह आज जो बाहुबली को सफलता मिली क्या उसी तरह का था क्योंकि हमारा तो जन्म भी नहीं हुआ था तो उसके बारे में क्या रिएक्शन थी कैसा ओपनिंग और
इसके बारे में बहुत सी कहानियां हैं। कुछ लोग कहते हैं कि जब रिलीज हुई तो फ्लॉप हो गई, तो सब ने कहा कि ये तो बैठ गई फिल्म। वो बिल्कुल सही नहीं था, लेकिन हमारे ट्रेड पंडित जो ट्रेड मैगजीन्स थी उनको ऐसा लगा कि ये फिल्म नहीं चल सकती और ये फिल्म नहीं चली है। मेरा ख्याल है वो पहले से प्रिपेयर्ड थे ये कहने के लिए, क्योंकि फिल्म जो जिसका बजट 1 करोड़ था वो 3 करोड़ तक चला गया। तो ये फिल्म कैसे पैसा बना सकती है, ये तो रिलीज के पहले ही फ्लॉप है। और इसी तरह उन्होंने लिखा कि ये फिल्म डिजास्टर है इंडस्ट्री के लिए, 3 करोड़ का खर्चा, ऊपर से प्रिंट पब्लिसिटी और ये सब, तो ये 4-5 करोड़ से कम तो खर्चा नहीं है इसका, कब रिकवर होगा, कैसे रिकवर होगा, इंडस्ट्री डूब गई। लेकिन जहां तक ऑडियंस का सवाल था, ऐसा बिल्कुल नहीं था। ये जरूर था कि ऑडियंस, जब मैं और पहली बार फिल्म देखने गया ऑडियंस के साथ, तो सन्नाटा छाया हुआ था। मुझे लगा कि क्या है, मैं दूसरी सिनेमा में गया, तीसरी में गया, हर जगह सन्नाटा। उससे कुछ ऐसे लगा कि तो वाकई गड़बड़ तो नहीं हो गई है, ये पंडित बोल रहे हैं एक तरफ से और ये मैं कुछ सुन ही नहीं रहा हूं दूसरी तरफ। तो एक सिनेमा है यहाँ वर्ली में, गीता सिनेमा करके, ओल्ड सिनेमा थी, आई डोंट नो इफ इट्स स्टिल देयर। वहां गया, उनके मैनेजर ने बुलाया, आप हमारे आए, इंटरवल हो चुका था। मैंने कहा अब इसको क्या कहना है, इसकी भी सुन लो। अब उसने कहा कि आपकी फिल्म जो है, प्रॉब्लम मेरा ये है कि ये जो आप देख रहे हैं स्टैंड सोडा फाउंटेन का, और ये जो कोक और सिगरेट और समोसे का, यहाँ कोई आता ही नहीं है। तो ये भी गया, मतलब ना कुछ खा रहे हैं, ना कुछ पी रहे हैं, और ना कोई आवाज हो रही है, चीज नहीं। इंटरवल में कोई सिनेमा सीट से उठना ही नहीं चाहता। तो सन्नाटा इस वजह से है कि इन लोगों ने आज तक ऐसी फिल्म देखी नहीं, इतना साउंड और ये जो सारी तिगड़में की हमने, मेहनत की, जो भी की, अब एक सेंटेंस में समझ में आ गई बात कि लोग चौकन्ने हो गए। धीरे धीरे ये वर्ड स्प्रेड हुआ, फिर चार पांच दिन के बाद फिर डायलॉग दोहराने लगे, अगर वाकई नहीं पसंद आती तो कोई होगा नहीं अंदर। फिर धीरे धीरे समझ में आया और सबको 7th और 8th week में जाकर मानना शुरू किया लोगों ने कि ये हिट है। और फिर 15वें हफ्ते में पंडित ने मान लिया कि ऐसी हिट नहीं बनी।